new session at Graduate Guru. We are doing consignment accounts and today we'll be doing question number 13. Let's read the sum. The Chennai consignment account in the books of Somi of Mumbai showed a debit balance of 11,250 representing the cost of 10 pieces of fancy boxes. So this is our goods, fancy boxes, and the consignee already has an opening stock. So here we are going to start with an opening balance, and opening balance diya hai cost pe, but the goods are being invoiced at invoice price, consigned at invoice price. So first we'll record the invoice price on the debit side and we'll record the reserve or the loading on the credit side. During the year, Somi sent a further consignment to Chennai of 40 pieces. So, ye during the year bheja hai. Last year mein he already had 10 pieces. Now we are sending him 40 more. Costing rupees 1200 each. Invoiced pro forma at 1350 each. So, this is again given as invoice price and cost price. So, we will find our loading. The freight and other charges amounted to 1575. The Chennai agent sent an account sales showing that 8 pieces from old stock realized 1050 each and 25 pieces from the current year consignment realized 1500 each. So, dono usne alag prices pe beche hai. Old stock mein se out of 10 he sold 8 and from the new consignment he sold 25 pieces. 15 pieces remained in stock unsold. So that is our closing stock. 2 pieces from the old stock. See, during the year we sent him 40. So 40 mein se 25 is sold. 15 is remaining, which is in the closing stock. But from the old stock, 10 pieces sold. But they are saying 2 pieces being unsaleable were returned by the consignee. So he said these 2 pieces are not being sold and he has returned them back to us. So there is some returns. For which the consignee spent 225 for packing and freight. So, for sending these 2 pieces back, he has spent some amount. Consignee is entitled to commission of 10%. So, here it's only normal commission. Okay, no extra commissions. Show the necessary accounts in the books of the consignor. So, in the books of the consignor, that is Somi, we have made consignment account, goods sent on consignment, and we have consignee's account. This time we don't know the name of the consignee. So we are just going to call him consignee. Okay. So let's begin the sum. Now here we are going to start with an opening balance. So it is like your opening stock. So to opening stock with consignee. And this we are going to record at invoice price and not the cost price. So, in the opening stock, we had 10 pieces and the invoice value of each is given as 1312.5. So, 10 into 1312.50. So, we get 13,125. Right? That is our opening stock. But, ye invoice price hai. So, just jaise hum goods sent mein agar invoice price hai, we record the loading. Waise hi yahan par on the credit side, I have to remove the profit element. So, that will be by opening stock reserve. And this will be the invoice price which we calculated minus the cost which they have given. They have said it showed a debit balance of 11,250 representing the cost of 10 pieces. So, 11,250 is my cost of the 10 boxes that we have sent. So, 13,125 minus 11,250, we get 1,875 as our opening stock reserve. This we are not going to record anywhere else. We don't generally prepare the consignment stock account. So, I am not recording it over here. Next is, during the year, Somi sent a further consignment to Chennai, 40 pieces costing 1,200 each, invoiced at 1,350 each. So, two goods sent on consignment, and we are going to record first at invoice price. So, two goods sent on consignment. They have said 40 pieces and invoice price given is 1,350. So, let's calculate and record that. 54,000 is our value of goods sent at invoice price. Second effect in my goods sent on consignment. So, by consignment account, $54,000. Now, because this is at invoice price, again on the credit side, I have to record the loading. So, by goods sent on consignment, this represents the loading on the goods sent or the profit, and 40 pieces into invoice price hai 1,350, cost diya hai 1,200. So, minus karke I get my profit, which is 150 per piece. So, 40 into 150, we get 6,000 as our loading or profit. Second effect in goods sent on consignment, to consignment account, loading 6,000. So, that's all recorded. Next is the freight and other charges amounted to 1,575. So, this is what the consignor is paying. So, to cash bank, and there are many expenses, they have just said other things. So, I'll just put down one common head, expense. The total amount given is 1,575. So, this is paid by the consignor. The Chennai agent sent an account sales. Now, he's already sold some goods and he's sending us an account sales. 8 pieces from old stock, the price is given, and 25 pieces from the current year consignment, and a price is given. So, let's record that. We have to take this money from the consignee. So, by consignee's account, this is for sales. And there are two sales. So, I'll just record the breakup. So, first is 8 pieces into 1,050. And then we have 25 pieces into 1,500. Let's do the calculations. 8 into 1,050 gives me 8,400, and 25 into 1,500 gives us 37,500. So, this is the total sales done by consignee. So, second effect in the consignee's account, to consignment account for sales, and we will take the total of the two sales. So, 8,400 plus 37,500. I will record the total sales in his account. So, that is 45,900. Okay. Then we have 15 pieces remained in stock unsold. But before that, we'll just see what he's returning back to us. 2 pieces from the old stock being unsaleable were returned. Okay. So, there is return. When you send the goods, you record on the debit. When there is returns, you record on the credit. By goods sent on consignment and this is returns. Now the returns is from the old pieces. Old pieces ka invoice value was 1312.5. So let's multiply 2 into 1312.5. We get 2625. This is 2 into 1312.5. And since it is at invoice price, I have to record it on the opposite side with the profit. So, two goods sent on consignment. This is loading. Loading on the returned goods. 2 into the difference between the two. What was it? It was 13125 minus 11250. Let's do one thing. Let's do a working note for that. So, working note for your loading on returns. So, total loading on opening balance. The total loading was 1875. I divide it by number of units opening, which was 10. So, divided by 10, and I multiply it by the number of units returned. Which is 2. So 1875 divide by 10 into 2, we get 375. So that is our loading on the returns. So that's what we are recording here. So we are recording it based on the working note 375. Okay, so this is our returns. Second effect, goods sent on consignment. So, this entry will come on the debit to consignment returns. Amount is 2625. And this entry will come on the credit by consignment. This is loading on returns, 375. So, all recorded, second effects given. Now, we go back to the stock that they were talking about. Sorry, before that, for this returns, the consignee has paid some expense of 225. So, let's record that to consignee's account. And this is expense on returns, 225. Second effect, I will take to my consignee. By consignment account, $225. And we'll also record our commission which is given before we record the stock. So, commission is 10%. So, again, to consignee's account for the commission, there is only one commission. And commission is 10%. 10% of total sales, jo humne yahan pe record kiya hai, 45,900 into 10%, I will get 4,590. As my commission, second effect in the consignee, by consignment account for commission. $4,590. Okay, so commission done. Now we come to the stock. So, buy stock with consignee. And as usual, we'll make a working note for that. So, working note 2
stock with consignee. Now here they have directly given us ke stock mein kitne units hain, which is 15 units. 40 the, usme se 25 bech diye. Ye 10, out of these 10, 8 sold, 2 returned. So that is over. Out of these 40, 25 sold and they are saying 15 are in stock. So the invoice price of units in stock. So units is known to us 15. And when I had sent the goods, hamara invoice price kitna tha? 1350. So I'll take that over here. 1350 into 15. We get 20,250. We add consignor's expenses to this. Our consignor's expenses are 1575. Consignee ke jo expense hai, they are for the return. So that will not come over here. They don't relate to 15 units. So only 1575, but the proportionate amount. So 1575 was for 40 units. So, for 15 units, how much?
So, I divide by 40, multiply by 15, divide by 40 into 15 gives me 591 after rounding off. So, we take the total 20250 plus 591,
we get 20,841. This is the value of our stock. This is what I will record over here. 20,841.
Here we have invoice price, so profit is included. So on the debit side, we will have stock reserve. Now for the stock reserve, I will take the number of units and I will take the profit per unit. So 1350 minus 1200, which is 150 per unit. So 15 into 150. 15 into 150 gives us 2250 as our stock reserve. So out of this amount, 2250 is the profit included. So we've done everything, all the entries done. Now one by one we close the account. So let's begin with our consignment account. Taking the credit side total first.
We get 77,241 as our total. Bring that here and subtract our debit side. We get 1101 as our profit. Let's close goods sent on consignment. The credit side will be more. Balance goes to trading account. So here we have 54,375. Bring that here. Let's subtract our debits from that. 54,375 minus 8,625. So I get 45,750 amount which goes to trading account. And finally, we close our consignee's account. They have not told us anything about he getting the cash or paying the cash. So we will keep it as balance carried down. So 45,900. And we subtract the two amounts from that.
225 and 4590,
we get 41085, and we will call that balance carried down.
Okay, so that's it for this sum. What was different over here? We started with an opening stock. Okay, from that opening stock, some were sold, some were returned. Okay, so in that returns, we've again calculated our reserve or loading on the returns. Fine, otherwise everything else was normal, even the commission was normal. Fine, so take this down, we'll go ahead with another sum. Let's go to question number 14. Messrs. Alpha of Mumbai consigned to Mega of Nasik 2000 bags of wool costing rupees 25 per bag. So that's the cost given, and they were invoiced at 20% above cost. So first we'll calculate the invoice price using this information. Messrs. Alpha paid 300 for insurance, 700 for carriage, 1000 for miscellaneous expenses. So, ye sare consigner ke expenses hai. Mega accepted a bill for half the amount of the invoice price. So, jo bhi hamari invoice price aayegi, uska aadha amount, half the amount, we will pass the entry for bill. Mega sent an account sales which shows as under. Cash sales of 1200 bags at 35 each. Credit sales of 600 bags at 40. So cash sales bhi hai, credit bhi hai. We'll record them separately. Mega took 100 bags for her own use at 32 per bag. So here, along with sales, the consignee is taking a part of the goods for his own use also. So it is like a sale for consignment. So consignment mein effect alag nahi aayega, and this will also go to Mega's account because we will have to recover the money from her. Expenses paid by Mega were godown rent 600, selling expense 1000. All these expenses are after the goods have been unloaded, so dono expenses stock valuation mein nahi lenge. Balance was remitted by a draft after deducting expenses and commission at 5% on sales and Del Credery commission at 1% on credit sales only. So the normal commission will be on total sales, and the Del Credery commission, they have specified that it is only on credit sales. Show consignment account and Mega's account in books of Alpha and Alpha's account in the books of Mega. Okay, so we've prepared those accounts, consignment account and Mega account. And in the books of consignee, we have Alpha's account, that is consignor's account. Okay. So let's begin. First entry is for goods sent. So two goods sent on consignment. We are not making the goods sent on consignment account this time. Two goods sent on consignment. And I will record it at invoice price. So let's make a small working note for that. Working note 1, invoice price of goods sent.
So first they have given us the cost of the goods sent.
And they have said that we have sent 2000 bags at rupees 25. Cost is 25 per bag.
So 2000 into 25,
that is
50,000.
This is my cost of the goods sent.
And they have said there is a markup. So to calculate the invoice price,
उन्होंने बोला है that you have to add 20% to the cost. Invoice price is 20% above cost.
So, अगर ये cost है, markup is 20%.
So, 50,000 का 20%, that's 10,000.
So, 60,000 is our invoice price. Okay? And that is what we will record in our consignment account. Over here 60,000 invoice price pe goods hai. So on the credit side we have buy goods sent on consignment, and this is for the loading or the profit on the goods. So buy goods sent on consignment, loading, and
we don't need to calculate it. We already have it over here. Ye jo markup hai, this is nothing but your loading.
So, yahi aa jayega over here in this entry, 10,000.
Okay, so that's done. We don't have goods sent account, so no second effect. This is Mega's account. So, we'll see what is happening over there. The Messiers Alpha paid 300 for insurance, 700 for carriage, 1000 for miscellaneous. So, let's record the expenses to cash bank. The consignor is paying the expenses. And let's make the list as given. We have insurance, carriage and miscellaneous expense. So, insurance, carriage and miscellaneous expenses. All given separately, 300, 700 and 1000. Now, this is paid by consignor, so no second effect anywhere. Mega accepted a bill for half the amount of the invoice price. So, now we come to Mega's account. Bill jab wo degi hame, we will not record it in consignment, but only in Mega's account. We are getting a bill from somebody.
So, buy bills receivable. And they have said it is half of the invoice price.
Invoice price is this that we calculated, 60,000
into half. So, that is 30,000. She is paying us an advance by a
bill for half the price. Now she is sending us an account sales for the details of sale and expenses. So there we have cash sales, credit sales and some goods she has taken for personal use. So on the credit side,
for the purpose of consignment, all these are sales only. Whether Mega takes it for her own self or she sells it to outsiders, they are all sales for us. So, first I'll record the cash sales. They have said 1200 bags at 35. So, 1200 into 35.
That is 42,000.
Then we also have credit sales. Credit sales is 600 at 40.
So, 600 into 40, 24,000.
And personal use of Mega. So, that will also come over here. And they have said it is 100 bags at 32. So, for herself, she has taken it at a lesser cost. So, 3,200.
So all these three amounts we have to recover from Mega. So therefore, by Mega's account, second effect in Mega's account to consignment cash sales, which was 42,000, credit sales, which was 24,000, and finally personal use, which Mega has taken away, 3,200. Okay, this time we are preparing the books of Mega, that is consignee, and we have Alpha's account. Okay, so this amount we have to pay to Alpha. So on the credit side, we are going to record by cash bank. This is for our cash sales. Amounts don't change. Same amount, 42,000 for cash sales. Now when we sell on credit, it is, you have to recover the amount from consignment debtors. So by consignment debtors account, this is our credit sales, 24,000. And finally, the amount which she has taken for personal use means she has purchased the goods. So, uske account mein wo purchase dikhega. So, by purchase account, this is books of Mega. So, Mega ke liye, Mega is purchasing from Alpha. So, jaise hum normal purchase entry karte hai, purchase account debit to creditors account or Alpha account in our case, 3,200. So, these three entries are recorded in all the places which where they were required. Now, expenses paid by Mega were go down rent and selling expense. So, again, for expenses, I'll go to the debit side and Mega is paying. So, to Mega's account, go down rent and selling expense, amounts are 600 and 1000. Second effect in Mega's account, by consignment go down rent and our selling expense, that is 600 and 1000. Okay, so this is done. Now we move on to the commission. Now let's record the commission which is payable to Mega. So commission is there and Dell Credery. I am putting it under the same heading. We already have two Mega's account here. So, normal commission and Dell Credery commission. Now, they have said commission is 5% on sales. Ab jab hum sales lenge, it will be the total of all these three. Kyunki for consignment, this is also a sale only. Okay? So, I will take the total and on the total, she will get 5%. So, 42,000, 24,000 and 3,200. 69,200 is the total of these three amounts into 5%. That is 3,460 is her normal commission. Okay. And Dell Credery, they have said 1% only on credit sales. So, yahan pe credit sales kitna hai? 24,000. So, 24,000 into 1%, 240 is her Dell Credery commission. Okay. So, the calculation is very important. Fine. First, commission on the total sales. Total sales will include what Mega has taken away for her own self. For consignment, that is also a sale. So, total sales pay 5% and on the credit sales, extra 1% of Dell Creditory Commission.
Fine. Second effect in Mega, again I have the account, I will continue in this list. So, Commission and Dell Creditory Commission. Commission being 3460 and Dell Creditory is 240.
We'll also record this same thing. All these amounts we have to recover. That is, Mega has to recover from Alpha. So, Alpha may over here, first Mega has paid the expenses. So, to Cash Bank, we have paid it on behalf of Alpha. So, we have to take it from Alpha. These two expenses, go down rent and selling commission. Go down rent of 600 and selling expense of 1000. These are the expenses. And for Mega, the commission and Dell Creditory Commission are incomes which she has to take from Alpha. So, to commission 3460 and to Dell Creditory Commission 240. Okay, so all the entries are recorded for the amounts payable to Mega. Now they are saying balance was remitted by a draft after deducting expenses and commission. So, jo bhi yahan par balance aayega, we will have by bank. But before that, we need to check if she has sold all the goods or whether we have something in stock. So, what was the number of units which we sent? 2000. 2000 may say we have sold for cash 1200, 600 is credit sale and 100 is gone for personal use. So, we still have 100 units in stock. So, there is definitely stock with consignee. So, buy stock with consignee and for that we will make a working note. So, let's go to our working note 2, stock with consignee. First, number of units as we just calculated. Number of units in stock. As I said, total 2000 minus the total of these three, that is
1200 plus 600 plus 100, which comes to 1900. So, my units in stock are
100. Okay. Now, how are we going to value it? So, first we'll take the invoice price
of goods sent,
that is the total invoice price of our first entry, which is 60,000. So, I start with that full 60,000.
I add the total consignor's expenses.
Consignor has spent these three amounts, 300, 700, 1000. So, total is 2000.
You will take all the consignor's expenses for valuation. And we add consignee's expenses up to unloading. Here we have two expenses
of the consignee, which is go down rent and selling. Ye dono expenses unloading ke baad hote hain, because once you unload the goods, you take them to the go down. So, both these expenses will not be taken.
So, nil for the consignee. So, my total value of goods sent is 62,000.
But this is
for how many units that we sent? We had sent 2000 units. So I'll divide it by that. And I will multiply by number of units in stock. That is unsold units,
which we calculated over here,
100.
So we'll multiply it with 100.
This will give us our value of stock. So let's do the calculation.
62,000 divided by 2,000 into 100.
We get 3,100 as our value of stock. Let's bring that here. We've left space for it. 3,100.
Ye valuation invoice price pe hai. So we have to create a reserve. So on the debit side to stock reserve.
And working note 3.
So let's go to working note 3 for stock reserve.
Now, if you'll see the beginning of the sum,
unhone kya diya hai? They have said costing 25 per bag and invoiced at 20% above cost. Yahan pe bhi humne wahi use kiya tha. We calculated the cost and then we added the loading of 20%. So let's do the same.
Cost price of goods in stock.
So, stock mein hamari kitni units hai? 100, which we calculated.
So, 100 and the cost price per unit is 25. So, 100 into 25, 2500 is our cost price. And to this, I just have to calculate my loading. I don't have to add it. So, loading or reserve will be the cost into the markup given,
which is used here also, 20% of your cost.
So 2500 into 20%, that gives us 500.
So our stock reserve, calculated in a slightly different manner this time, is 500.
So let's bring that here. 500 is our stock reserve.
Now we just have to close the accounts. All the entries are done. We will get a balance over here, which they have said it will be paid in bank draft. So we'll take that to bank.
Let's close the consignment account first, as usual, to get our profit on consignment.
So our credit side total is 10,042.24, 3,200 and 3,100.
We get 82,300 as our total.
Let's subtract the debit side. 60,300, 700, 1,000, 1,600, 3,460, 240 and 500.
We get 14,500 difference as our profit. Now we need to close Mega's account and find the balance, which will be bank. We'll receive amount from Mega. So it will be by bank. We are receiving by a bank draft. So let's take a total of our credit side first. That will be more. 42,24 and 3,200. 69,200 is my debit total. We will subtract our credit side. So minus 30,000, 1,600, 3,460 and 240. Balance is 33,900, which she will pay us by bank draft.
Same thing over here, same entries.
So I will get the same balance over here, mirror accounts, as we have already done. 69,200 total I will take here. The credit entries here are on the debit side here. We have not recorded the bills receivable. So let's record that over here. She has given us a bill for Mega. It becomes a bills payable. 30,000. She had given it to us in the beginning as an
advance. So when I subtract, I will get the same balance. 33,900.
So this will be to bank account. She will pay us via bank draft. Okay.
So is samme alag kya tha? That there were some goods taken away for personal use by consignee, but we saw that uspe bhi commission calculate hoga. Okay. Other than that, the stock reserve calculation was slightly differently done. Fine. So these are some different points about this sum. You can take this down and let's wind up this session for now. Next session, we'll be doing the last few sums of this chapter, and this chapter will be over. Thank you.